How do you make an object in Java? Using keyword new. New ABC. That's all. So our ABC is A is equal to new ABC. We saw something called object serialization. We created an object and using object output stream, file output stream, we saved it into a file. Using object input stream and file input stream, we deserialize that object because serialization means series of ones and zeros. Deserialize got the object back. We got the object back from the file. You made an object, correct? Did you use new keyword? No. Second way of making object, deserialization. New keyword is not the only way. You realize it? From object deserialization, from the file, you got the object back in memory. There is another way of making. And there is more ways. We will see another way now. Okay? So what we do is, one more project. Class clone test do we have an object emp class? Yes, copy that. Okay, we don't need serializable. So let us create object of EMP. Just copy the EMP from server. EMP E 1 is equal to new EMP 111 int string. A long number. Okay. L created object of EMP. We'll create one more object equal to E1 dot clone. So here is an error. It is from the type object. One more method of object learning. The clone method is an object class. So it is available in all the classes in Java. So we are calling the clone method to make a clone of employee. But it is protected. Clone method in object is protected. Protected means what? Only child can access it. Protected method only child can access. My clone test cannot access it. I'm trying to access from clone test, not possible. So what is the best thing to do? Override clone in EMP. So go to EMP and override or shift S. Override implement methods. What do you want? Only clone. Okay, take clone and say okay. So I'm overriding that. Okay. So he's doing same thing, but only thing I'll make it public. Correct? Now all can access it. Made it more visible. Made that public. Don't need to do anything, just call super doctor. Okay. Because we do not know how to draw. Only object knows how to draw. Right? I'm just overriding clone method in EMP. Made it public. Now issue solved. Okay. So when I clone it, what is it returning? It is returning object. What is EMP into? It is EMP. Correct. This is returning object, and where I am putting it? I am putting in E2. Is it okay? No, no. You cannot put object into E2. So what you need to do? You need to add cast to EMP to make the compiler happy. We know clone is returning EMP, but compiler does not know. How to make it happy? Just write cast. Now compiler will ignore it, but still there is error. Surround with try catch, because it is throwing exception. You need to try catch it. Okay, so surround with try catch. So declaration will, let us put it outside. Here we put E2 is equal to now put a sort here E1 equal E2. Will it give true or false? If it is same object, it will give true. If it is totally different objects, it will give false. Check and see. There is a problem. What is the problem? Clone not supported exception. Who is doing the cloning? JVM. From one object in the memory, another object will be created. JVM has cloned your original object, exact same, but any object. Okay? So, what JVM needs to know, is this EMP clonable? It is not clonable. Why? Same here. You heard about serializable, right? Here there needs to be a interface called implements clonable. This also does not have any methods. This is also what kind of interface? Marker interface. Clonable is also a marker interface. It marks this class with certain information for the runtime that something special about this. This is clonable class. Only then your JVM will agree for it. See? Null's happy. You can print separately. See, exact duplicate, but they are two different objects. That even equal to shape says that the references are different. Okay, they are two different objects, but the value is same. They are the same. They are, it is duplicated everything.
I can change it if you want. Event dot set mobile and print again. Did E2 change? No, only E1 changed. Now, if I add one more in this private department, DPT is a class. Okay, so one class, now this becomes a complex object. DPT another class, created. Create class DPT. Okay, put private int id private string name alt shift s constructor from the fields. Okay, alt shift s getter setter. Okay, so this is a department class. Then, so I can create DBT inside the employee. So here also I need alt shift s. I need to create a constructor with department. Don't remove the constructors. Eh? Also add a setter getter for department. Okay, get department, set department. Also to string I'll change. This is not having department. Remove it and add again. So it will come with department. Okay, to string I modify, no problem. But constructor don't modify. Add a constructor. You can always overload. So create employee accordingly. New DBT ID. Okay, add a department. Effect is same. Okay, department does not have a to string. Put a to string there. Okay. So only mobile got modified. E2 did not get modified. Same effect, only department expires. Extra department. Right, which is this department number ID. Both are having, if I change what will happen, let's see. That's what I'm trying to do now. I will do one thing, instead of set mobile, get department dot set name to HR. I change the department. For whom? For E1. Only for E1 I change. Will E2 change? should not.
He too also changed.
Why? Department is not cloned. It is sharing the same department. This is a problem.
And this is called shadow cloning. Okay? In shadow cloning, department is not cloned.
Because that is an object. String is immutable, number also no problem. But DPT is not a number or a string. It is mutable. It can change. So in department I changed IT to HR. It got changed. Both got changed. Why? It's the same department. I did not clone it. How to clone it?
I should make this also clonable. And override clone method. That's it, nothing to do here. You want to make it public. Okay. Clone overridden. And here what you need to do, get the clone first. EMP E is equal to super dot clone. Okay. And cast it to EMP. No change now.
And returning the D. But I'll make something in this E.
E dot set department with what? E dot get department dot clone. Let cast it.
Compile it here.
So E dot get department dot clone.
Get the clone of the department.
Cast it to department and set it in the employees department. That new employee and return the employee.
Now the new employee is not having the original department. It is having the clone of the department. So if you modify the original department, nothing will happen.
See? Untouched.
Why? What you modified was the clone of the department.
You modified it, but where it got modified? It got modified in E1. So E2 is not affected.
Why? When I cloned it, what happened? I took the department's clone and set it back in the employee as a new department.
Correct? So what exactly I did? I made this also clonable. I made this clonable in the clone thing. So I can call clone. So I said E dot get department. This clone, right? After cloning, I got a new EMP. That new EMP is get department I took, and I said clone. The whole thing, I set it in the employees department.
So set department, the clone of the original object. Now the E which I returned from here is having all new things, even the department new.
Correct. And this is called deep cloning. For deep cloning.
Each object inside your object is also cloned. Nothing is shared.
It's working, right? See? HR IT.
E2 is having still IT. E1 got modified. Third way of making object, clone. First is new keyword, second is object deserialization, third is clone, method clone we call, but here you need to have an original object. From the original object you can get a clone. With new keyword, no need of it. From the class directly you get, deserialization is the class, the object is inside a file. So you can deserialization, get it.